Alright, so Microsoft just released a new Copilot formula in Excel, which brings AI right into your spreadsheet. But there's a catch. Copilot only works with Microsoft 365, and you need a Copilot Plus subscription, which costs around $20 per month. And I know not everyone wants to pay extra each month or upgrade to the latest 365 version. So in this video, I will show you a different way to use AI in Excel. One that doesn't need a subscription, has no usage limits, and keeps all your data on your own computer. It also works with older version of Excel, and it runs on both Windows and macOS. This solution is an Excel add-in I built, and it's called XLlama. With XLlama, you can run AI models directly inside Excel with no internet connection needed. So you just download any open source model you want, and then you can use that model right inside Excel. Okay, and to show you how it works, I'll use a workbook I downloaded from Excel Campus. So John recently made a YouTube video on his channel showing you some use cases for Copilot, and I thought it would be fun to take that worksheet, but instead of using the Copilot formula, we will use XLlama. Now, spoiler alert, XLlama of course won't match every feature of Copilot. But if you want a private solution with no ongoing cost, I think it could be still a strong alternative. And by the way, I will also leave the link to John's YouTube video in the description box below, so you can see the Copilot feature in action. Okay, so with that said, let us dive in and let me show you how you can use AI in Excel without any subscription. Alright, so here's the example workbook. On the left you can see the text, and next to it the Copilot formula. Now, just to be clear, this workbook was downloaded from Excel Campus, so I don't personally have access to Copilot, but I can still see how the result looked like. And you can also see here how the Copilot formula works. You basically just enter a prompt and provide some context. In this case, the prompt is to extract the items from the data and create a comma-separated list for each row. And the context is here the range B4 to B20. Now, the neat thing about the Copilot formula is that you only need to enter your prompt once, and you will get back the result as an array. Now, with XLlama, it works a little bit differently. So once you install it in, you will also get a new formula, which is called XLlama prompt. Here you can also enter your prompt, but the difference is the result will only return in the active cell. But since this is just a normal formula, you can also drag it down. And because there aren't any usage limits or extra cost, you can use the formula in as many cells as you want. The only limitation here is your computer's power, because since the AI model runs locally on your machine, it might take some time if you use it on a large range of cells. That said, if we look at the result, you will see that we get almost the same outcome as with the Copilot formula. Alright, and next up, if you want to split the result into multiple columns, that is also possible with the Copilot formula, as you can see here. So after the prompt, you can even specify the output, and again, you only need to write the formula once. However, when I'm using XLlama, I'm using two separate prompts here. One to extract the name, and the other one to extract the items. But just like before, when I drag down the formula and wait a bit, I will get back the same result. Now let me also mention that the result also depends on which model you are using. So if I go to my settings, you can see that I currently have 4 different models installed on my machine. Right now I'm using the Gemma 3 model with 4 billion parameters. Later in this video I will also show you how to install more models, and in general how to get started with the add-in. Okay, and with that said, let us move on to the next example. The idea here is that I want to organize a potluck. On the left side I have the names of my friends, and next to it I track the items they are bringing. So as you can see, some friends don't have an items listed yet, so we could ask the AI for suggestions. Now in John's video, he first categorized each item, since he was later using the group by formula to run some analysis. After that he asked AI to make recommendations for the blank rows. Now to do this with XLlama, we will take a slightly different approach. So to categorize the items, I will just drag down my formula, and you will see that we get almost the same result back. Now for the AI recommendations, we will need the context of the entire table. For that, we will use the Run XLlama button. So I have written already my prompt here, and it's basically the same idea. So the AI should recommend some dishes for the blank entries. So with that in place, let me copy this prompt to my clipboard. Now I will select my table and press the Run XLlama button. Here I can now insert my prompt. Once I press enter, the entire range will be analyzed, and I will get back the result in a new sheet. And here I can now see the names and the dishes they should bring. But notice, some names are still missing and a few items are duplicated, like the chicken wings. So it is definitely not perfect, but once again, the result also depends on which model you are using. Alright, and with that in mind, let us move on to the next example. Here I want meal suggestions based on the ingredients I have at home, which are listed here in this table. With the Copilot formula, you just write one prompt and it will list the result in every row. Now again with XLlama, we will use a slightly different approach. So I have written my prompt here in this cell and I will copy it to my clipboard. However, this time instead of returning the output in a new sheet, I want it in a specific cell. So in the settings menu, I will tick this option here. Now when I select my range, click the Run XLlama button and enter my prompt, I will be asked where I want the output. So I will choose this cell here. And after clicking OK, the AI analyzes the range and I will get back the 7 different dinner suggestions. Okay, and with that, let us move on and do some sentiment analysis. Here the Copilot formula returns the result in 2 columns. With XLlama on the other hand, we will split this into 2 steps. First, I will ask the AI to rate the review from 1 to 10. Then I will ask if it's positive or negative. And as before, I can now just drag down the formula and you will see that the results are almost the same. Alright, and with that, let us take a look at another use case, which is standardizing dates. So you might have a column with different date formats. With XLlama, you can just specify the desired format in your prompt and then drag down the formula. And again, you will see that we get the same result as with Copilot. Okay, and for the last example, let us also standardize some product names. Here you can see a list of products with different spellings. With Copilot, you would enter a prompt and provide the context, which is in this case a range B4 to B25. Now again, with XLlama, we can do something very similar. But this time, inside my prompt, I also added extra context by listing all the product names using the text join function. So when I run this formula and drag it down, we again get almost the same result. Now once you have the actual result, it is actually a good idea to convert the XLlama formulas into values. Otherwise, if you change some cells, the formula might run again and again. And to avoid that, you can convert them into values. And here you've got 3 options. You can, for example, convert the selected range into values like I'm doing now. Or you can convert all formulas in the current sheet. Or you can convert everything in the entire workbook. Now, as I said, this will help keep Excel running smoothly and prevent unnecessary recalculations. Alright, so those are the main features of XLlama. And just to mention it one more time, this will also work offline because everything runs locally on your machine and none of your data ever leaves your computer. Also, you are free to install as many models as you want. If you go to the settings one more time and click here, you will be redirected to the XLlama documentation. There you will find a video showing how to install more models. You can also find them on the xLlama website, where you will see lots of different open source models. The only real limitation here is your computer's power, because bigger models also require more resources, but that said, in most cases a smaller lightweight model is in many cases more than enough. Now if you want to get started with XLlama, check out the first link in the description below. That will take you to my website. On my website you will also see there's a free and a paid version. Now obviously the free version has some limitations, but you can find all the details on my website. And once you get XLlama, you will also receive a welcome email. Inside that email is a link to a quick 5-minute getting started video, where I walk you through the entire installation process step by step. Alright, so there you have it, a private and much cheaper alternative to Copilot. So let me know what you think about Copilot and XLlama in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.